So we're going to talk a little bit about acupuncture. I did an acupuncture exam on him before we started. Great, that'll work perfect. Acupuncture is another complementary therapy. I use it a lot in horses that maybe have some minor lameness issues that we're doing some things to help that. And we want to get those muscles moving good. Do a lot of musculoskeletal. I do a lot of back sore horses. Back sore horses do fabulous with acupuncture. So I'm going to run a quick exam. We'll talk about the needles a little bit. I'll show you some. We'll put a couple in, and that'll probably be all the time that we'll have. As I did an exam on him earlier, so there are specific points on a horse's body that may indicate we have problems in places. So he responded up here. He also has a point right down here on his neck. Although, since I adjusted his neck, he's no longer showing up there like he was before we started. We'll come around his scapula. He's got some sore triceps muscles. One thing that responds also very well to acupuncture. Back sore horses, I can drop them through there. Just with that amount of pressure, they're significantly sore through there. He is not a back sore horse, not at all. Ulcer horses that have ulcers, will respond at one point in the middle of their back, okay, and that'll be the only point you'll have. They'll also respond to a point that comes down here along their side. So if I have a horse that I'm maybe doing an acupuncture exam and about right there, he nearly wants to drop, but nothing through his low back, I'm suspicious that he may have ulcers. He, I'm sure, is used a lot. He kind of responds at what I call performance points. Gluteal muscles, tricep muscles. So most of what he shows me is that he has musculoskeletal sort of things. You're all right. Again, I'm going to repeat the exam on this side, see if he is symmetric side to side. And he's got those tight triceps. We're gonna come over the back here through those gluteals, off the tip of his tubercoxae. So if I were to do his exam, he wouldn't say to me, he doesn't tell me, oh, I have this one specific spot that's a problem. Hock horses have a tendency to be sore, low back, a couple points on their butt. Stifle horses tend to have issues in their neck, at a specific spot in their neck, and higher on their hiney and lower on their hiney. So I can get a lot of ideas, maybe a horse that just isn't quite moving right, even with just my acupuncture exam. These needles are very, very small needles. And again, we put them at a very, very specific location to have an effect. On him, most of what we're doing is for the effects of his muscles, okay? Most horses tolerate needles well. Now, my acupuncture horses don't like me necessarily as much as my chiropractic horses like me. Some horses will respond to needles differently than others. Some of them hate them so much that you get a chance to do maybe four needles and then you're done. But they do have a significant effect on them. So I'll put a few in here over his back. And like I said, if there's anybody that has questions here, feel free to ask them. It's kind of a central point along his back. These needles are very bendy. Take one out here and show you. They are bend, bend, bend. So when they go in, they're very sharp. They're coated, so they go in quickly. There is a little pinprick sort of pain when the needles go in, and then after that, the area numbs. What we do is cause a little bit of microtrauma at the area that we put the needle in. That microtrauma causes release of different chemicals from the body, basically, that go up to the brain and say, you know, relax to muscles, or if it's a painful issue, it will help to downregulate that pain in the brain. And I picked the really long